I was just like, I've watched everything there is to watch, and I'm so upset because we have so much. I need to decompress. I need to decompress with something. Hi, welcome to the House of Valentina. I'm Valentina, and today we're hanging out in my sunroom, which happens to be my favorite place to sit with a cup of coffee, and I always have a stack of books in this room. And I feel a little bit guilty because the kids are upstairs doing their homeschooling, so I probably only have a very few quick minutes to get this done. And my husband is on a bunch of conference calls today, but I thought it would be really fun that since this is French week here at the House of Valentina and we're all kind of stuck wherever it is that we are, wouldn't it be really fun to go virtually to France? And I know there's some of you that actually live in France. Please go outside on our behalf. We would really appreciate that. But for the rest of us, we're gonna have to take a virtual trip to France. And my favorite way to take a virtual trip anywhere in the world is by reading a book, by watching a show, maybe a movie, and of course, listening to music from there and just imagining if I've been there or what it would be like to actually go for a visit. And so I thought today would be really fun to share some of my favorite French books that I do own. I do have a couple still on my list that I'm hoping to get soon. And I'll share with you some of my favorite movies that I've watched and a few that when I started thinking about this idea, I was like, wow, there's probably other movies that I haven't seen, and I'm so embarrassed. There are some really classic movies that I've never seen, and I am going to use this lockdown as an excuse to start watching some of these. Maybe in the wee hours of the night. I am not going to front here because watching movies during the day isn't really happening for me because, again, kids, husband, you know, this craziness. So let's just jump straight in because I have so much to share. Oh, before I jump into this list, let me just tell you. So we have two things that you should know about. First of all, there's a PDF you can download that you can click through on the titles, and it will take you straight to the books, and it will also give you all the titles of the movies. And I will leave a link for that in the description box. Also, since this is French week, we will be ending the week with we'll be doing a live from our kitchen. We're gonna be making French food one of the days this week, and we'll be doing a fun live on Friday night at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And the way to have access to that is to join the Inspired by V Facebook group. I'll leave a link for that as well. That way you guys can go and join there and be a part of the live. The last one was so much fun, and it was just, oh my gosh, it was just a blast. So I hope you'll join us for that. So, okay, let's jump in because I'm so excited. I've already mentioned this book in my last video. It's one that I've been looking at over the last few days. This is French Country Cooking by Mimi. Her name is Mimi Thoreson. This woman bought a chateau in France with her husband. They live in it with their kids. They renovated it. And the woman who originally owned the chateau was this amazing, well-known, she's truly world-renowned cook. And her recipes are in this cookbook along with Mimi's. If you only choose one book out of this entire lot, get that one. I mentioned this in my last video as well, and I'll just mention it again really quickly. In the French Kitchen with Kids, these are easy recipes. That's always my biggest fear, and same with the last book. Everyone says that all this French cooking is so complicated, and so I am 1000% guilty of not really ever trying French cooking. And these recipes are so doable, and we are going to be trying them out this week. So you can let us know. Would you rather that we cook out of this one? Please say the other one. Yeah, say the other one, because we're probably gonna cook out of that one. She's got all kinds of great cakes and stuff. This one has a really good recipe for a ratatouille, though, that I'm really excited about trying. Now, you may not be able to tell because there's so much light in here right now, but this book has been worn, it has been loved, it has been opened. This is Coco Chanel, An Intimate Life. I've read every single last page in this book. I absolutely love Coco Chanel's story. I think that she's a remarkable woman. I think that she achieved so much, and she was so ahead of her time. And as a woman running my own business and trying to run a family and everything else that goes along with that, I need this. I need these amazing women that just do amazing things to encourage me, and I think that this is one of those books. You will love this book. In fact, I'm just gonna just show you both of these books, Coco Chanel, The Legend and the Life, and then the Coco Chanel, An Intimate Life. Both of these are awesome. I've read them over and over. I love them. I love the stories. I love, this one actually has pictures in it. And I thought it was fascinating because I think for me, I like the history that goes along with somebody's story, and that her life was taking place in such an incredible time period. So the next one is In Paris by Jeanne Damas, and she is a style icon truly in her own right. And I always think it's interesting to visit somebody's book and feel like you've visited inside of their mind. And I think that that's what really makes me drawn to this book, is that it's very French. It feels very French. It feels very, approachable, and it's got great stories, and the fashion in here is really cute. And I just like seeing what she was interested in. And I think that this is a really great one. I have mentioned this book before, so I won't go into massive detail, but if you haven't seen some of my older videos, you may not have seen about this. How to Be Parisian Wherever You Are is dog-eared and beaten up, and I just absolutely love this book. If you have any interest whatsoever into the mind of a French woman, this is like tips and tricks for how to be actually French and how to think like the French. And I just think that it's really great. It's all about how to go au naturel and how they do their makeup and how they think about fashion. And I just really love this book, as you can tell, because it's all worn and tattered, and it's wonderful. I love it. My neighbor gave me this book. Well, she didn't give me. There's a little post-it note in here that says, please give it back. this book belongs to your neighbor. Give it back. But The Art of French Vegetable Gardening, she let me borrow this because we were talking over the fence the other day. Clearly not close to each other. And she was seeing that I've planted a pear tree and a pomegranate and we have blackberries, and I'm like so into this idea of having a potager, which is the French edible garden that they have. And this book is fantastic. It's an older book, but it has so much information inside of it. The pictures are beautiful, and it really has like, I've been reading it, like genuinely reading this book, and I'm really enjoying it. It has a lot of good information about how to actually plant a garden, how to think about planting it. There's just really good information. So if you are a beginner gardener like I am, but you really love the French garden and the way they have this knack for making it beautiful, because sometimes I've seen vegetable patches where I'm like, ew, that's really ugly, but not the French. Of course, they have to add a little bit of chicness even to their vegetable garden. And I think you guys are really like this one. And finally, one of my favorite books, which I've told you that you will be hearing about more and more because I'm obsessed with it. This is Maison, Parisian Chic at Home. And I've mentioned this in a recent video about my favorite books. And it is just absolutely gorgeous, truly a peek inside a Parisian home. These are real people's homes, real lives, and I think that it's interesting to see how people actually live, not just, I mean, I know that they styled them for, they styled them for the magazine. They didn't just like open the door and say, oh yeah, like don't move those shoes. I'm sure that they did style these, but it's amazing. If there are two books that I would say that you should get, it's the first one, the Mimi Thoresen cookbooks, and this one. So I always have a running list of ones that I really want to add, but I'm slow. Like, I have to know that if I'm gonna spend $20 to $50 on a book, it better be worth every last cent. So the ones that I think will be worth every last penny are The Perfect French Country, Beautiful Interiors, the sneak peeks that I've seen make me believe that this is a book that I will absolutely love. So I definitely have that one on my list. Also have The Little Paris Kitchen on my wish list. Rachel Koo is so adorable. She has her own show in England. So I've watched her cooking show. She has to be one of the most charming, lovely people on the planet. And she went to live in Paris for a while. And this book is her favorite Parisian recipes. And of course, I could not do this video without mentioning that I would want to have Mimi's other book, which is The Kitchen in France. And I've got to have that book. In fact, I think my husband may have ordered it for me for Mother's Day, but don't tell him I know that, because I definitely didn't look in the Amazon cart or in the past orders. Oops. I wasn't trying to cheat or look, I just did. Yeah. Okay, so I'm not gonna go through the music on this video. If you wanna download the little PDF, it'll have all of my favorite music. This is music that we actually listen to at home. Like, if you stopped by on any given day, especially once Jack gets home, because he has the whole house like wired with all the speakers and all the sound system and stuff. And the first thing he does is he walks in the house, he takes off his shoes, he turns down the air, and he turns on some sort of French music. That's just how it is. It's just the rhythm here. So this is the music that we actually listen to in our house, and it just really transports us there and makes us really happy. So that'll be on the PDF for you. Let me just quickly run through some of the movies though. I just finished watching Marie Antoinette. I don't know how, I had never actually seen that movie. You guys are probably gonna be like, oh my gosh, how did you not see that movie? But you know, when we were overseas, we had limited access to movies and everything. All the digital age hadn't, you know, quite kicked in the way that it has now. So I feel like I'm catching up, and Marie Antoinette was incredible. I can't believe I've never seen that before. I will definitely be watching that again. Just the scenery in it was incredible, and I realize that it's not 100% historically correct, but I sit there while I'm watching the movie and I look up all the factoids and I educate myself on what really happened, or at least as best as we know. So totally recommend that one. I just watched Moulin Rouge with my daughter last night. It was her first time ever seeing it. It's just such a great movie. Definitely very theatrical. I think it's really fun. I love Coco Before Chanel. I think that movie, of course, you guys know, can tell I'm obsessed with Chanel. I love that movie. I think it's really great. You get to see inside people's homes, and this, for me, it has to have good scenery. The story has to be great too, but the scenery has to be perfect. Otherwise, I'm bored. And that one is definitely worth watching. My husband and I watched Midnight in Paris last night because we were going through the list, and I was like, I don't want to recommend these if we don't like them. And he's like, oh yeah, we watched that a long time ago. That was such a great movie, where he goes back in time and he's visiting all these famous people, Hemingway and the Fitzgeralds, and it's just such a blast. For me, you're gonna notice that a lot of these have a historical reference to them. That's kind of my thing. So if it's yours, then you're gonna love this list. I have not seen Funny Face. Can you believe that? I have never seen it. That's on my list. Maybe tonight that's what I'll go to sleep with. I'm definitely gonna be watching that one. And La Vie en Rose, I haven't seen that. I don't know how. Oh, I haven't seen Julia and Julia in a really long time. That one was a really cute one, where she makes all the recipes that Julia Child made, but you have two stories kind of simultaneously. It's been forever since I watched it. So I'm gonna go back and watch that too. I'm so excited. I'm not kidding. I was just like, I've watched everything there is to watch, and I'm so upset because we have so much. I need to decompress. I need to decompress with something that's really fun and beautiful at the end of the day. And so I'm so excited that I now have a few movies that I can go and watch. Oh my gosh, I just watched Suite Française. I don't know if you guys have seen that, but it's beautiful, and it's set in the French countryside in a chateau, and it's gorgeous. Is it in a chateau? Actually, it may not be in a chateau. I don't know. It's like a French country estate at the very least. And it was just so beautiful. I wouldn't watch that one if it's late at night and you really don't like violence, because some of it was a little hard to swallow. But the scenery in that one and the sweetness of it, yeah, it got me. Yeah. And then there's a bunch more that are gonna be on the list if you wanna download the PDF. But I just thought it would be fun for us to, I don't know, maybe one day we will actually have House of Valentina travel trips that we can join and we'll go somewhere. I mean, wouldn't it be so fun when all this is over if we were able to rent like a night at a chateau in France and just all meet there? Wouldn't that just be such a blast? I know that I would absolutely love it. So if you would too, then leave us a comment down in the comment section and please, 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 a moment of selfishness. If you have a favorite French related book, I love novels and any of that kind of stuff. I don't have any of those. There's gotta be something out there, right? That I know there is. I just couldn't find any. So if you have a book or a movie or a playlist that you really love, we would be so delighted and so thankful if you'd put that down in the comment section. It'll not only be for us, but for those that are watching that are trying to entertain ourselves during this time, and that would be huge. So we would really appreciate it. But I think that's it for now. I'm gonna sip on my coffee a few more minutes and check on my kids, make sure, especially the youngest, that he's actually getting his work done. I'm a little scared that he hasn't popped in during this video. He keeps making appearances right in the middle of them, which, you know, when he hasn't come down, it's like, oh boy, oh boy. As a parent, you guys know what I mean. The silence is the scariest thing. But I hope that you've enjoyed today's video. I hope it's inspired you. And we will see you in the next one. Bye.